the man sleeping with this children and so on? Why against them?
Do you know, I've thought about this, I've thought, oh, am I getting interviewed now?
if you don't want to be camera,
don't worry. No, I don't mind being,
just to have a nice, friendly discussion.
I genuinely believe it isn't. There's organisations or little groups called, have you heard of Dark Justice?
No.
They're going in search of paedophiles.
I saw it online. I saw it online.
But obviously, they don't put anything out until the guy's been prosecuted or they're getting arrested. Yeah. But they're going catching people.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I kind of speak for Tommy Robinson personally.
Yeah, forget that.
What I'm saying is that man has brought an issue. It is a hot topic. He's brought an issue about, and from that, everybody's looking now at paedophiles. Doesn't matter what the colour is.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what the colour. I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
But you're sitting in the house and you're thinking you're a plain living Muslim, and all you hear is Muslim this, Muslim that, and that. There's a generation of hate growing up.
Yeah, no doubt, any doubt, yeah.
And it's not good for anybody.
Anybody. Without any doubt, that's what I'm saying. But what surprises me, to be honest, because I will give you a book as a gift, you can read it. Because if we are really concerned about the country and about paedophiles, let us study who's really doing these crimes.
Oh, we know who's doing them, don't we? When we went into Europe, when they signed the agreement, the Prime Minister at the time is on record as being a paedophile.
Not just him, I will show you many.
He had to sign the declaration because we're blackmailing him.
I see. I'll show you many.
Do you know what I mean? So we know it goes right to the top. And yeah, do not fear. The British people will root them out. Democracy, no, I'm telling you, democracy will rule in the end. I mean, all this thing about Brussels and like the EU, we will get out the EU, we will get our power back, we will hold our politicians responsible for the actions.
Yeah, but a lot of them have not been held responsible for the actions.
Oh, we will.
Sorry, I'm not going to generalize every British person, but we know a lot of British people go to Thailand and Vietnam to go to disabled children.
Never been to Thailand.
That's what I was going to ask Tommy Robinson. I want to know. Sorry, brother.
In Thailand, it's a beautiful country
as
well.
I want to see Tommy Robinson's passport if he's been to Thailand. I want to see. Some people want to see if they've been to Thailand. But I want to tell you something because I know you have to go. What I don't like when the people say Muslim, grooming, gangs. Doesn't make any sense. It's like a taxi driver runs over a child and say, Muslim taxi driver runs child over. What has to do with the Muslim? What has to do with the religion?
You know,
understand just what
if
they do?
If I ask you, who are you?
I am Shamsuddin.
And where are you from?
Algeria.
Right. So you're not English.
No, I'm from Algeria. Right. Right, yeah.
So are you an Algerian Muslim?
An Algerian Muslim, yeah.
Right. Now I'm Roman Catholic. I was christened a Catholic. Don't practice, don't believe in any God. Personally, I'm not going to insult anybody.
Yeah.
But for me, so much hate in the world. Can there really be a God?
Of course he can.
The point of what I was going to make.
Well, one person speaks.
Every time somebody introduces themselves on TV as a Muslim, it's like, I'm a British Muslim, I'm an Australian Muslim, and it's as if. So, for me, I believe in England. I'm English.
That's a nationality, but what is your system belief?
But I'm not.
Yeah.
No, I mean, but that's it. See, culturally, I'm just English. I'm not bothered about who you pray to or doesn't bother me.
But you, before I go to move to another point, and I said, I know you have to go. Let's go back to the main point. The main point here, why they are titling this with a Muslim taxi driver, a Muslim grooming gangs. Doesn't make any sense. You know why? Because in Islam, those grooming gangs, those grooming gangs, according to Islamic legislation, they will receive severe punishment. But in this country, we put them in a hotel. You know what I'm saying? So don't blame Islam, because in Islam we have a severe punishment. Sorry, brother. So those who are doing those actions, they are not followers, the true followers of Islam.
That's why the people in this country have got to get the power back.
Yeah.
There's too much power at Westminster, isn't it?
Mm.
They're making decisions for us. Did I want to go to Iraq and bomb the place?
Yeah.
No. And neither did the British public.
That's true. One of the biggest.
You can't say that you buy all the products and you buy all the cars. Fuck that. Just one second. One minute. It's not about this.
You can't blame him. Understand? Because it's true. The biggest protest in Britain was against going to Iraq.
Yeah, it's known.
So we cannot blame him. It's known.
Right? So the individuals aren't to blame.
I agree 100%.
Exactly.
That's what I'm saying. That's what when I speak about British, some
so
British
when you
people.
Go on mainstream media, it's yeah. Muslim this, Muslim that, but they're not talking about the individual. Is that what you're saying?
That's what I'm saying. So yeah. Muslims, don't put Muslim because.
Do you lead with, an Algerian Muslim? Is that how you introduce yourself?
Not all the time. I don't have to go to every person. I'm an Algerian Muslim. I'm just Algerian. If they ask me, I'm a Rulu.
It's asking me a question. I think the mainstream media latch onto that, the importance of your faith.
Yes, I'm saying that.
They're pushing it all the time.
That's what I'm saying.
So all they do, the mainstream media, is create division. I've had my eyes.
I'll tell you something. BBC News. BBC
propaganda channel.
No, BBC journalist. That's what I believe. BBC journalist contacted me. Oh. There's a video of me you can watch online. Shamsi exposing Anjum Chowdhury follower. There was a guy came here. He's an Anjum Chowdhury follower. Are you aware of Anjum Chowdhury?
He's my neighbour.
Anjum Chowdhury?
I live in Durham, and he's been in Franklin Prison. I only live down there. I've never had lunch with him.
The point is, I'm going to mention. So to cut you, Anjum Chowdhury's follower came. I went and I exposed him. And I said, you are a follower of extremism, you are an extremist, don't speak about Islam, and so on. So this BBC journalist contacted me. So I thought he likes the video, he wants me to speak about the true Islam, what is Salafism, because people say Salafis, I'm Salafi, okay? And people say Salafis are the terrorists. That's not true. Rather, Salafis waged a war against the terrorists in the 90s, when the West were cooperating with Bin Laden. In the 90s, our scholars warned against Bin Laden, when the West were helping and aiding Bin Laden. You see, so I said, okay, that's a good idea. Then afterward, he contacted me again, asking me about the other guy.
Wasn't he in the employ of the CIA?
That's what I'm saying. That's my point. Right. It's my point that it's happened in the West.
It's not about the American individual. It's not about the,
it's about the government.
English individual. Yeah, it's the government.
Yeah.
So if we get the power back, yeah. We change the government.
Yeah, but you don't.
So we're all together.
You don't want some of us to get the power back.
Yeah, but we're all together. We're all together.
Without any doubt.
Foreign policy.
We have to help one another. So, it was my pleasure speaking
to
you. I know you have to go. Otherwise, I'll speak about God.
What was your name again?
Shamsi. What was your name?
Michael Hopper.
Michael, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Take care. Come to yourself, man. Have a nice week, day. Take care.
Okay, who's Michael?